Welcome to Information Service Engineering. This is lecture number 3, Natural Language Processing, part 2. Welcome also to the notebook for the chapter 2.5, where we have talked about NLP challenges, and one of the challenges was ambiguity. And here, in this additional chapter, I want to give you a walkthrough through the ambiguities notebook that we have prepared for you. So let's switch to the notebook we have here. So it's about lexical ambiguity. And to play around a bit with lexical ambiguity, so with polysemy or homonymy, we have selected WordNet for you. So WordNet is a huge lexicon, and this provides lots of denotational definition of each word and represents words' interrelations and hierarchical structure of that. So simply follow the link, learn a bit more about WordNet, and see how this is organized. WordNet is a huge lexicon, which is organized in types of synsets, which means you have a word, and for each meaning you have a so-called synset. And if you want to look up this stuff, so you can simply see how this works, that we can look at different meanings of a specific word by looking at specific synsets. So first, what we have to do here is we have to import the natural language toolkit in Python, and of course we have to download WordNet here. And so we will import WordNet from NLTK. And first thing we want to do here is we want to look up the WordNet synsets for the word star. You remember our famous star example for semantic ambiguity. And what you see here, if we look at that synset, you see here a list, and you see here for the word star, we get back several synsets. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And you see here more interesting information. So here you see star N01. N means this is a noun, and V here means this is a verb. So we can get a bit closer to the definition. So let's see what's the definition of exactly this third variant of star here. So we want to have the third synset, and we want to get its definition. So we look at it, and the definition means this is the definition or the meaning, a verbal description, of exactly what's the meaning of that synset of the word star. And the third synset here is any celestial body visible as a point of light from the earth at night. So this is the star in the sky. Of course, now you would be interested in all of these definitions. So we do this in the next section here. We look up all definitions. Furthermore, we want to look at the exact lexical information. So is it a noun or is it a verb? And we want to look at synonyms that are available for this synset, which means other words meaning exactly the same like the synset we are looking for. For this, we are going through all of the synsets. I call this here sense. Within the list of synsets we see here, and then we print for each one, first of course, the name, then the lexical information we have for that, then the definition, and in the end, all the lemma names, which are here the so-called synonyms. So let's simply try to do that, and you see what's the outcome of that. So the first one, star, it's also a noun object. As you see here, it's also from astronomy, a celestial body of hot gases that radiates energy derived from thermonuclear reaction. So this is really the astronomical star. Then we have here ace, which also is referred to by as star, because star is one of its, or should be one here, of its synonyms. It's also a noun, and it's referring to a person, and this is someone who is dazzlingly skilled in any field. So this is then a star, or also an ace. Number three, star is any celestial body visible as a point of light from the earth at night. So this could also be a planet, for example, but we call it simply star because we see it there. Number four, person, also interesting for us. Then this is an actor who plays a principal role. So also you see here that the synonyms star, principal, and so on and so on and so on. Let's have a look at the verb. So here is a verb, star, stative. So this is a verb, feature as the star. So star can also be a verb. And you have one in creation, which means here to be the star in a performance. And you have here something which is expressing change, mark with an asterisk. So you change something, you star something out of whatever. And you have here leading, so star can also be used as an adjective and indicating the most important performer of a role. So he is the star performer, or, you know, the star actor, the leading actor. So these are synonymous adjectives for that. So you see simple Python code where you can look up the stuff here in and play around with what you find here in WordNet. Furthermore, what you also can look at, so simply look at all of the methods you can use there to get more information from WordNet. But one I want also to show you are the so-called hyponyms. These are more general terms for a given synset. So we again take here number 3, which is the star in the sky. And we are looking for all of the hyponyms and want to see, you know, all hyponyms, not only one, but the entire closure. So we want to see all of them. And it starts here. You see here our star. Next hyponym would be celestial body, which is a natural object, which is something which is a whole, which is something which is an object, which is something which is a physical entity, and which is something which is an entity. So you have here the entire transitive closure of hyponyms, so more general terms leading to our star number 3, which is the star in the sky. Okay. Another nice thing we have prepared here for you as a small algorithm in this notebook is WordSense disambiguation, which means we want to find out for an ambiguous word what is really the meaning of that word, given a specific context. Like, for example, we have a word like here, we have the astronomer loves the star at the movie who plays the lead role. Of course, we know then the star, the actor is meant. We know this by the context we have given here within that sentence. And there is a really simple algorithm, and this algorithm is called the LESC algorithm. And what it does, so we look here simply for the maximum overlap of this sentence with all of the synset definitions we have for the word star. You saw we have the definitions over here for everything. And then we simply look, you know, what's the number of overlap? So how many words overlap? And it's most likely that, of course, here in that specific sentence, we might achieve the best overlap with, let's say, the star, not the star in the sky, but of course the star of the movie. Because we have here the word movie, we have here the word play, and we have here the word role. So the idea here is to look up for the maximum overlap of the sentence, which is the context here, and the synset definition. And the synset here, for example, for the correct one would be an actor who plays a principal role, which mean here with plays and role, we would have an overlap. So this is then the simple LASK or LESC algorithm introduced by Michael LESC in 1986. So this is a baseline algorithm. This is, of course, not one of the best ambiguity resolvers, but it's a baseline. So what you do here is we are getting all of the definitions of all of the senses of our word star, or of a specific word. So this is arbitrary because we define here a simple method. And then we are looking for, so we are splitting. So now all of these lists, and then we are looking for overlaps of all of the words. And in case we have an overlap, so if there is an intersection, then this is the number of overlaps, and we are looking for all of the overlaps for all of the senses. And if one is larger than the other, we keep in mind the larger one. So which means we are looking for the one with the largest overlap. So rather basic. And then we return exactly the sense that has the largest overlap here. We start here with our sentence number 1. The astronomer loves the star of the movie who plays the lead role, and the ambiguous word we are looking for is star. And then simply, okay, we apply this LESC algorithm we have just defined and want to see what's the outcome. And now let's do this, and you will see here the result is a synset star number 4. So now number 4, an actor who plays a principal role. To see whether this also works with another star, I have here another sentence for you. The astronomer loves the star that twinkles in the sky so bright. Okay, again, ambiguous word is star. Now answer number 2, let's compute this. And you will see here are number one, a celestial body of hot gases that radiates energy derived from thermonuclear reactions in the interior. Great. So that one, the star, is then associated with sense number one. So you see, this is really a vanilla baseline algorithm that is quite easy. And of course, it depends on exactly these definitions that are given here. And of course, then also of the sentence you have here. If you are paraphrasing here several words that don't occur then in the definitions, then of course it won't work. However, this was only to show you that you can play around already and do first natural language processing tasks with the stuff we have already talked about in the lecture so far. So play around with it, have fun, and see you then in the next part of the lecture.